Well, I've already recorded this video, but I forgot to switch on my audio recording. So now I feel like Charlie McDonald when he had Tim Minchin over. That's a really old school reference for YouTube. Anyway, hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be talking about what your first lucid dream will most likely look like. If you're new here, my name is Giz Edwards. I'm a lucid dreaming coach and entrepreneur based in the UK. And on this channel, we delve into subjects such as lucid dreaming, entrepreneurship, and more to make your lives more enjoyable, fulfilling, and relaxed. This is the fifth video in our lucid dreaming playlist, which is linked down below in the description box. And with that out of the way, let's talk about what your first lucid dream will look like. That was too long for an intro. I need to shorten that down. You might have the expectation that your first lucid dream is going to be some fantastical ride where you rise up to heaven so that you could kiss the face of God and you can dive into the depths of hell and slap Satan over the face with a wet sock. But truthfully, your first lucid dream will be none of these things. Your first lucid dream will probably suck, to be honest. And I have seen people talk about their first lucid dream, and it normally falls into one of two different variants depending on what kind of first lucid dream they have. I will explain. The first kind is accidental. When you have your first lucid dream accidentally, you might not even know what lucid dreaming is. And usually people are very young, normally about five. You've had a nightmare or something and you accidentally realize that you're in a dream. You could be chased by Durin's Bane, the Balrog of Morgoth, and then realize, wait a minute, this is a fictional character. I think I'm in a dream. Often in accidental first lucid dreams, you have very little dream control outside of what you would expect to do as a human in waking world. So you could go and sleep with a celebrity because you could actually physically do that with your own body. Maybe not you. You don't really do any supernatural things. I will caveat that by saying probably not. I don't want to give your expectation setting to the standard where it's impossible to do so. Otherwise you'll go on thinking it is impossible. It's not impossible, but improbable. What you probably won't do, as I said, is dream control or doing some supernatural stuff. Or you probably won't look around your scenario, your setting, the place that you're in. You won't investigate the situation. You'll most likely still follow the plot of the dream. Now, the second type of first lucid dream is purposeful lucid dreaming. This is when you find out about lucid dreaming, you practice, and then you have your first lucid dream. Now, this could be because of the culmination of days, weeks, maybe even months of skill building, practice, and effort, all accumulating to this one first lucid dream. You popped your cherry. Well done. You did it. The problem here is that usually you've got so much adrenaline rushing through you when you realize that you're in a lucid dream that you wake up prematurely, a premature dream evacuation, so to speak. I'm full of all these innuendos today. So when that happens, it could be because of a number of reasons. Your heart rate increases, your breathing rate increases, adrenaline, full stop. A lot of different things can happen. So you tend not to spend a lot of time in a dream because you wake up very quickly. And this is known as a layer one lucid dream, a dream in which you realize that you're dreaming and you wake up straight away. I will go into more detail about layers of lucidity in a future video, but now is not the time. We're talking about expectation setting. Now, I've had both of these experiences in my life. My first accidental lucid dream was when I was 5 years old and I had recurring nightmares of being chased by Godzilla. And it was going on for like a month. And to the point where my mum got sick of me waking up crying in the night, sweating through the bed sheets and asking for mum and, you know, all those things. And she said to me, next time you're in a dream and you see that Godzilla, you know you're dreaming. So do something about it. So I did. That night, I went into the dream. I realized that I was dreaming because Godzilla was again chasing me. And I was with a dream character friend and we hid behind this electric fireplace, which I don't know how I did that, but it was a dream. Anyway, I turned to my dream character friend and said, don't worry, I'm dreaming. This will be over soon. I will wake up. And I woke myself up and never had that lucid dream. Oh, sorry, never had that nightmare ever again. So fast forward 10 years, I'm about 15 years old and I have my first purposeful lucid dream. I hear about lucid dreaming and I learn everything about it that I could possibly get my hands on that day, because I remember having my first lucid dream when I was 5. So I knew it was possible. I did everything that they said to do for the first night. I went to bed and during the night, I would periodically, as I was falling asleep, pinch my nose and see if I can breathe through it. I open my eyes this one time during the night, and my eyes are kind of like glued together, like I had conjunctivitis or something, and it was all cloudy, and I was like, oh, that's weird. And anyway, I pinched my nose and I could breathe through my nose, and I realized, oh my god, I'm dreaming. And I instantly woke up and I was in bed again. So I had both examples of my first kind of lucid dream. And if you've had an accidental lucid dream when you were a kid, you'll probably experience both as well. The point of this video is to set expectations for lucid dreaming. Lucid dreaming is a skill that you build over time, and it takes a long time to develop this skill. When you learn how to lucid dream, part of that skill building process is learning how to stop getting so excited. Over time, the novelty of lucid dreaming wears off and you become more in tune with the dream and less likely to wake up straight away. We will get into that in the video series, don't you worry. And speaking of the video series, the next few videos in this collection will be about expectation setting and what is most likely going to happen when you have your first lucid dream and all that kind of stuff. So if you want to stay around for those, click that subscribe button. If you're not here on the day of posting, there is a link to the playlist in the description box below. Click on that. And with that out of the way, I will see all of my subscribers here on Wednesday for another thrilling video about some random topic. So until then, bye. I've really hurt my throat, like seriously. I feel like Steve-O. My throat feels like how Steve-O talks. You know, when he talks like that all the time. Yeah. Oh boy. It hurts. My throat hurts. So I'm going to take a couple days off. Anyway, didn't need to know that. Bye.